Okay, now we have a service to get the list of courses from the server. We need to use this service in this courses component. So, first we need to add a constructor here. Constructor. Because a constructor is where we initialize an object. So here we need to create an instance of our courses service. Something like this. Let service be new courses service. Once again, I'm using the auto import plugin. So when I press enter, it automatically adds the import statement here on the top. So import courses service from current folder courses.service. All right, now back in the constructor. So we have a service and then we can initialize this courses field like this. This.courses, we set this to service.getCourses. Let's test the application and make sure everything works up to this point. Save. Okay, we get the same list. Beautiful. However, there is a problem with this implementation. The first problem is that by using this new operator here, we have tightly coupled this courses component to the courses service. So this is exactly like the problem we had earlier. If we implemented the logic for consuming an HTTP service inside this component, we wouldn't be able to unit test this class. Now we put this logic in a different class, courses service, but because we're directly creating an instance of this class here, we're still tightly coupled to that implementation. The other issue here is that if in the future we decide to add a parameter to the constructor of courses service, we have to come back here and anywhere else in our application where we have used this courses service and add a new argument, like one. So anytime we change the constructor of the service, we end up with multiple changes in our application code. So this is very fragile. So what should we do? Well, instead of we creating an instance of the courses service, we can ask Angular to do that for us. So we can delete this line here and add a parameter in this constructor, call it service, of type courses service. With this, when Angular is going to create an instance of our component, it looks at this constructor, it sees that this constructor has a dependency. This dependency is of type courses service. So first it creates an instance of the courses service and then passes that to this constructor. Now with this implementation, if we change the constructor of courses service and add a new parameter, we don't have to modify 100 places in our code to reflect the change. Angular will automatically instantiate a new courses service object. The second benefit of this implementation is that when we're going to unit test this courses component, instead of supplying an actual courses service to this constructor, we can create a fake implementation of this service that doesn't use that HTTP service on the backend. In other words, we have decoupled our courses component from courses service. So here's the lesson. When you use the new operator like this inside a class, you have tightly coupled your class to that implementation. You cannot change this at runtime. But when you add that dependency as a parameter of a constructor, you have decoupled that class from that dependency. Now, we're not done yet. We need to instruct Angular to create an instance of courses service and pass it to our courses component. This concept is called dependency injection. So we should instruct Angular to inject the dependencies of this component into its constructor. As simple as that. That's dependency injection. A lot of people think dependency injection is so complicated, but it's really a $25 term for a 5-cent concept. So dependency injection means injecting or providing the dependencies of a class into its constructor. Now, Angular has a dependency injection framework built into it. So when it's going to create an instance of a component, it can inject the dependencies. But in order for that to work, we need to register these dependencies somewhere in our module. So let's save the changes. Now we need to go to our app.module. So here's app.module. Okay, look at this ng module decorator. Here we have a property called providers. which is set to an empty array. In this array, we need to register all the dependencies that components in this module are dependent upon. For example, our courses component is dependent upon courses service. So we need to register courses service as a provider in this module. So here I'm going to add courses service. Now, if you forget this step, dependency injection is not going to work. Let me show you what happens. So I'm going to comment out this line, save, back to the browser. We get a blank page, so that means something is wrong. Let's open up Chrome Developer Tools with Shift, Command, and I on Mac or Shift, Control, I on Windows. Look at this error, no provider for courses service. This is an error that you might see quite often when building Angular apps. So the error is telling us that we have not registered courses service as a provider in our module. So back in app module, I'm going to add this courses service here, save, back in the browser, and we have the list of courses. Now, one more thing before we finish this lecture. When you register a dependency as a provider in a module, Angular will create a single instance of that class for that entire module. So imagine in this module, we have 100 components and 50 of these components need the courses service. In the memory, we're going to have only a single instance of courses service, and Angular will pass the same instance to all these components. This is what we call the singleton pattern. So a single instance of a given object exists in the memory. So a quick roundup. Back in our component, we added courses service as a parameter in the constructor, or in other words, as a dependency of this class, and then registered this as a provider in our app module. With this implementation, when Angular is going to create an instance of this component, first it will instantiate its dependencies, and then it will inject those dependencies into the constructor of this class. And this is what we call dependency injection.